Come in, Mrs. Bannerman. I think you'd better sit down.
Thank you, sir. I prefer to stand.
I'm afraid I've some rather bad news for you.
What is it?
Well, it's going to be a bit of a shock.
Oh. They've caught him.
Your brother.
They'll hang him for sure.
No, Mrs. Barrowman. He's beyond the law now. He's in more merciful hands. We came upon the poor fellow as we were crossing the moor. He must have missed his footing and fallen over the cliff. No further need, Barrowman, to signal to him from the window or take food out to him or give him Sir Henry's discarded clothes.
Go, Sir Henry. It was all my doing. Barrowman here wanted to tell you all along so as you can notify the police. But he was my kin, my old kin. Even though he wasn't never any good.
We understand.
He won't hold it against Barrowman. Will you, sir?
Of course not. Now take her along and see that she's all right.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Well, it's nice to get that inn cleared up, for their sake as well as mine.
It clears up everything, I think, Sir Henry. That poor devil must have been completely demented.
And that accounts for those dreadful noises that we've been hearing from time to time.
Exactly. Your troubles are over, Sir Henry.
I really am most grateful, Mr. Holmes.
Oh, not at all. I've done little enough. But you can sleep peacefully in your bed now and commence to lead the life of a happy country squire.
Well, not for a little bit, I'm afraid. I'm off to Canada again.
Canada?
Beryl, Miss Stapleton and I are going to be married.
Miss Stapleton.
A very charming young lady. Congratulations.
Everything's arranged. Her brother's giving us a farewell party tomorrow night. We'll be married in London the following day, and then off for a honeymoon to Canada.
My congratulations too, Sir Henry.
Thanks. What luck you're here. You and Dr. Watson will be with us tomorrow night.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm afraid I can't. I must hurry back to London. And so should you too, Watson. We'll have to report to the police here about that convict in the morning, but there's a train leaving early in the afternoon.
Oh, what a pity.
Beryl will be dreadfully disappointed.
Now, we'll remedy that when you come up to London.
You must dine with us before you sail.
Well, there's the old boy himself, Sir Hugo. Hugo, the beast of the Baskervilles.
Not a bad bit of brushwork by Ransom, one of the minor painters.
Oh, I don't imagine it's very valuable.
I can't quite agree with you, Sir Henry. One day it might prove to be of the greatest value. Well, we must be going.
There's still one or two little points, Holmes, that I can't for the life of me reconcile with your theory about that poor demented convict.
One or two little points?
But surely you can't mean that he was in London 3 weeks ago? Sent that letter? Stole that boot?
Of course not.
Then who the devil did?
The same person who was responsible for the death of that convict last night. And will try again to murder Sir Henry tonight.
Tonight?
Unless my imagination has run away with itself, and I don't think that it has.
Then why are we rushing up to London, leaving Sir Henry entirely unprotected?
We're not, my dear Watson. We're just giving the impression of rushing up to London. In a minute and a half, we'll be in Okehampton. There, we'll catch a train back to Dartmoor. And if my surmise is correct, we'll nab our man in the act.
But if you know who it is, why all this roundabout rigmarole? Why don't you have him arrested?
Because I've no case. Not a shred of evidence that would hold in any court. The only way is to catch him red-handed. To catch him in such a way that there's no escape. No alibi. That means gambling with Sir Henry's life.
But you can't...
Gambling to save his life. But we've got to take that chance. Otherwise, the shadow of sudden death will be forever hanging over his head, and sooner or later... Here we are, Okehampton.